So we have talked about thyristor-based rectifier circuits, right? In this video, I'm going to talk about a thyristor-based circuit, which is not a rectifier, which is, you can very well call it as an AC to AC converter, right? The circuit is the same as that of a triac, which we use to regulate our fans, right? So let us see the circuit, how it looks like. So you have a source, right, and you have a back-to-back connected NT parallel thyristors T1 and T2, right? This combination of back-to-back connected thyristors is not back-to-back, this is the combination of NT parallel connection of SCRs, right? This is sometimes is known by different names by different people working in polyectronics. It's also called as, some people would call it as a static switch, because this could be very well used as an AC switch. It's static in nature, there's no mechanical part, right? This same basic operation is also applicable for a triac, which is a device which is popularly used to control the fan speed. Now what happens here, let's just for simplification, let's start with the understanding of what if we connect a resistance here, R. So let's say this is your input voltage Vin, and I'm giving trigger pulse to T1 here and trigger pulse to T2 here. What would be the output voltage? The output voltage, when I give a trigger pulse to T1, input is positive, and therefore the output voltage starts following the input voltage. Now when zero comes, because there's a resistance, the current becomes zero, and therefore T1 turns off and the voltage remains zero at the output, unless T2 is turned on at a point. Now when T2 is turned on, if you see, the input voltage is negative, right? So T2 will short circuit the input and output, and therefore the output voltage will also be negative. So you have to see that this is not acting as a rectifier, but this is actually acting as an AC to AC converter. So the input is also AC voltage, output is also an AC voltage, right? Wherein the output voltage is as given by this waveform. Again, you can call this angle as firing angle alpha, and you can define the, you can calculate the output average value is obviously zero. You can calculate the output RMS value. Right, so you can calculate the RMS value of the output voltage. That would be the RMS value that is being applied across the load resistance R. As you see that as we increase alpha from 0 to pi, the output RMS value would change from the RMS of the input, which is let's say Vm by root 2, to 0. Right, if alpha is 0, input voltage, output voltage are same, so therefore they have equal RMS. When alpha tends towards pi, the output voltage has negligible magnitude and the output voltage RMS is almost zero. Using this, by changing the firing angle of these back-to-back, these anti-parallel thyristors, you can control the output RMS value, and that is the principle by which our regulators control the speed of fan. So essentially the output frequency remains the same, no change in frequency, only the output magnitude changes as we change the regulator knob, which controls the firing angle alpha. Now a small thing, if you see, what I have considered here is a pure resistance R. In actual, you may have an R and a small L also, right? And if you have L, then the current will not become equal to zero when the voltage becomes zero. The current would become zero a little bit later, right? Because inductive, so current is lagging. And in that case, your output voltage waveform would get slightly different. It will not remain the same. It will not come to zero. It will not stop from here. The output voltage might continue till some more time and might actually stop here or here, depending on how much of inductance you have in the circuit, right? But for a pure resistance, this is going to be the output voltage waveform. Okay, so this was all about thyristor based rectifier circuits, and we have talked about a thyristor based AC to AC circuit also here. Now we would talk about, if you see our original discussion which we had in the beginning, wherein we saw that there were different types of semiconductor devices, right? If you remember, there was a diode. Now diode we have been using extensively till now. Then there was thyristor, which in this chapter we saw a lot of examples of thyristor based circuits. And then next is the MOSFET, or rather a fully controlled device, which could be either a MOSFET or an IGBT or some other device. So now we would see some of the circuits which essentially utilizes these fully controlled devices.